Hi Taurus, welcome back to Omkara Tarot and let's do your love read now. This is the first one for the month of December, Taurus. Let's see what wonderful things hopefully are in store for you now in December for love. And these are general collective readings, Taurus, will not resonate with each and every one of you. So take what works for you and just leave the rest. So let's begin. My angels, spirit guides, please bless this reading for Taurus and send them the messages and the guidance they require now for the month of December. Thank you. So Taurus, let's see, you know, we have to start with the angel blessing card, right? Nothing starts without a blessing. So let's ask the angels. My angels, please give my Taurus gang a blessing or an advice card to top the reading for their love life. Blessing on an advice card for my Taurus gang. This one, all right. Thank you. Let's put the rest back, Taurus. So the card I have for you here, Taurus, is faith. What do you need to have faith in? I would suggest in yourself, after all your past readings that I've done, I think a lot of my Taurus friends are now gathering up a lot of self-respect and a lot of self-loving and having faith in their own capabilities. I think that's what it should be done first and foremost, but let's see why this card is here now. Welcome back all my subscribers. Thank you for being here. Thank you for being part of this family. I'm so blessed to have you all here today. Thank you so much. And thank you for all your comments. I mean, I really look forward to them. The minute I post the video, I'm waiting. Okay. Thank you so much. And if you're new here, we welcome you to the Omkara family. Do join us, subscribe to the channel and become part of us. We welcome you in. So Taurus, I'm going to be doing something a little more different this time. Of course, we'll have our spread the way I do it, person A, person B, and in the center, we'll have your mutual energies, which is what is mutual between the two of you, any advice, any guidance, but we'll also be doing some dialogue messages this time to see what would this person want to say to you and vice versa. Yes, there is a bit of delay going on, I think, right now, Taurus, in your love life or something, because the Nine of Pentacles is right now in reverse. Okay, so let's take some messages. So Spirit, if Taurus had to say something to their partner or their partner to them, what would that be? What would Taurus like to say to their partner or their partner to them now? One more. Oops. All right. I have my three cards here. And let's take three more from a separate deck. One. Two. Oops. One more, Spirit. One more card for Taurus. All right. Put these here, Taurus. So the first card I have for you here, Taurus, says, you were in my dreams again last night. I always dream of you every night. You're my ultimate fantasy. So there's somebody, I don't know whether this is somebody new you recently met, Taurus, or somebody old, but there is somebody dreaming of you. Or it could be you dreaming of someone, Taurus. You'll have to tell me. Second card says, it drives me crazy when you behave like a spoiled child who takes my love for granted. Yes, I love you unconditionally, but I'm not your parent. And quite frankly, your behavior takes the piss at times. You need to act like an adult for our relationship to work. Yes. So I think this is somebody old, and the partner is very upset that, you know, you're taking me for granted here. I can love you, but... I mean, don't take me for granted. It was, I think, very, very clear there. So let's see the third one. I enjoy dating and keeping things casual as I'm not wanting to settle down yet. So that's the problem. That's why they've been, you know, pretending to take the other partner for granted, is because they don't want to get them too comfortable to feel, oh, we are in a relationship and it's just the two of us and we're going to end up together. So even though one person is having a lot of dreams and fantasies about their partner, they want to still keep dating and keep their options open here. So that's the major problem. Fourth card. When you told me you thought I was too good to be true, I was one of the few and good and true people in your life. So now I think the confidence level is increasing of the person who's been left behind to say, hey, you want to go, you want to go, go. Like, you know, if you want to go see if the grass is better, you know, greener or better on the other side, please go ahead. But you know, you've told me that I'm the best, which is correct. You are the best. I have been loyal to you. Can you honestly say you've been loyal to me? Loyalty is knowing that you can trust someone with your mind, body, heart, soul, life, and life. Being a faithful and reliable partner always. So that is the major issue here. One partner wants, is being loyal, is loving unconditionally. The other person also loves, but they are not committing because they have a fear that they'll get stuck in a situation. They still want to date. They still want to go out, meet other people. And I think a couple of cards are the same as I think Aries or Libra. So in case you're dealing with one of those signs. Next card. I want us to build trust and walk on a foundation of friendship before we have a romantic and sexual relationship. So I think this is now after this problem has happened. I think one person has now become a little more intelligent to say, you know, you just come in for sex and passion and you leave immediately. So it's better that, you know, first you show me that you're worth being a friend, a good friend who can be there in, you know, time of need, or just be there for me when I need you, and only then, you know, can we move on to something more. Or this could be somebody new that maybe you've met now, and this is how you want to build your next relationship. Next card. If only you knew what I have been through to be at your side. Do you really know the sacrifices I have made? It hurts like hell when you push me away, when all I do is fight for you and for our love. So there's one person who's very sure of the connection. I think you both are actually, but one person is a little more immature than the other. Still wants to play around, doesn't want to commit. And the other person is very clear that, hey, you're my soulmate. You know it, you feel it, but you don't accept it. So that's the problem. And that's the reason for this delay in coming together. So Taurus, by now you may have understood whether this is your story. If it is, stay on. Let's open the cards and see what we can expect. So let's see. What's your first card? Person A, the Empress. Strength. Nine of Wands. The Chariot. The World. And the Knight of Swords. Okay. Person B has the Ten of Pentacles. Eight of Swords in reverse, Queen of Swords in reverse, Six of Swords upright, Six of Pentacles, and the Justice card. So, I think on person A's side, somebody knows that they have found their perfect match. They know that I'm dealing with an Empress, yet I think this person doesn't treat this Empress as an Empress. They come in, they are a bit immature. Now look at this pair. It's the Empress to the Knight of Swords. So here is a queen above all queens. And look at this person coming in with a sword in their hand and, you know, coming in rash and being rude or just dipping in. And after they say what they have to say, maybe fight with this Empress, they'll just leave. So what's the Strength card then, Spirit? Yeah, that's the reason I think this empress is now closing off and putting a kind of a barrier between the two of you. I think this empress is becoming stronger and stronger each day now, and putting a halt, guarding her energy. And that's the reason this relationship seems to have kind of come to a little bit of stagnancy, where there are delays, because this empress has now recognized this king of cups to be the way he is, emotionally immature and emotionally manipulative, only showing their hand when they want something from the empress and then pulling back. So chariot spirit, chariot. Yes, yeah, somebody is pulling away big time from their person, even though heart of hearts they know this is the one I want. This is my man, this is my person, this is the person who I've always dreamt of being my happily ever after. But I think that I have a empress here who's now regained her strength, is now putting a little spoke in that wheel to say, hey, listen, you come to me. If you come to me, you come correct or you don't come at all. And hence the delay in the connection. The relationship, though, is still open here. It hasn't really shut down, but nobody is really putting in any work. Nobody wants to kind of... maybe the empress was at one point, because there is a soul bond, soul connect. There is a feeling, yes, we are lovers or we are meant to be. The feeling is there, but nobody is really putting in the work right now. I think this empress has really kind of ascended now. Left the door open for the masculine to come in if they have to and show them that they have matured, but I don't think they really have. They're still showing up as the Knight of Swords. I mean, the same Knight of Swords as was there in the beginning of our reading as well. So what's this Knight of Swords spirit? Knight of Swords. Knight of Swords. One more. This is quite an equal match here, Taurus. I see somebody coming back here, returning. Okay, somebody wants to return back here swiftly for some fast communication. I think now whatever was a bit of an illusion to them, or they were not sure, or they were not... they were pretending not to be sure about. I think this little bit of separation has totally cleared the air for this masculine as well, where they're saying, oh my God, I see it clearly now. This is my person. I mean, I was not seeing clearly the value of my partner. My partner is the most gorgeous one. They are the ones that anyone would like to have. And I had them and I kind of took them for granted here. Exactly how the message cards came. But now I think somebody is seeing the light. When the sun comes next to the moon card, that means all secrets or all illusions are now in the open, and somebody wants to rush back and have some swift communication here. So let's see what's happening on the other side. Ten of Pentacles with the Eight of Swords. Yes, person B did want to have a happily ever after. I think they have been at crossroads for a long time, but now things have become clear to them. They've realized that there's no point my waiting forever and ever for somebody who's not going to bring me that commitment. Yes, I wanted it. Yes, I saw myself in a happy relationship which could have lasted the test of time, but now I think I've realized this. My person was very immature, childish, and maybe it's not ready right now to bring me what I really need from a relationship. So I think person B is now kind of planning their future. They are seeing what else is out there. They have the world in their hands and saying, if you can't be on my level, then I might as well move out to see what else is out there. I don't want to live stressed all my life. I want to release all this stress and burden from my life. And yes, I'm angry. Yes, I am angry. I am bitter. But it's no point my staying in this scenario forever. If you don't want me, I don't want you either. Okay, so I have somebody on person B side who could be the feminine here saying, I don't want a reconciliation. Okay, I don't want to have the stress of always waiting for a reconciliation. Yes, I'm angry with you. I'm very, very upset with you because what I thought was a soulmate bond, a soulmate connection, you've ruined it for me because of all your past fights and you're not committing to me and you're always being so immature and not giving me the respect that maybe I commanded in your life. So I have one person who is now moving away from all this troubled time and going off to find, yes, victory for themselves. I have somebody here who's now moving ahead now, leaving all this trouble, going for their own happiness, for their own victory, and their own beautiful life ahead. They're looking, the only thing person B is looking for, as I think, equal give and take. They're looking for a partner who can give them what they deserve. If I give you 5, you give me 5 and we, you know, turn it into a 10. I don't want to, I'm not your mother, like this card said. I'm not your parent that I'll just keep putting in the work and then you'll just be immature and ride in and ride out and say what you have to without being concerned about my feelings. That doesn't work in a relationship. So Six of Pentacles, Spirit. Six of Pentacles. Yes, I think this person B has had it now. They are now a little bored of this offer from person A. They feel rejected. They feel sad that all they got from this relationship was a dictator, maybe somebody who was very controlling in the situation, maybe was always trying to direct the relationship to go the way they wanted it to go. And when they were done, they would just sneak out and leave them. And they never really got this Six of Pentacles, which they now desire, okay, which is their right to have a partner which gives them what they deserve here. So what's this Justice card, Spirit? Justice card. What's the Justice card for person B? Somebody is looking for what they deserve. It's simple as that. They know that they are worth the Queen of Pentacles. So now person B is on that quest to look after not only themselves, their pentacles, their work, their life, and they know, I think the self-confidence has now come to this feminine here, who now has the faith in themselves that I'm good, I can find anyone I want, and I'm not going to wait around for somebody who's not going to treat me right. I'm going to bring justice to my own life by now looking after and nurturing myself. Why should I wait for somebody else to, you know, tell me what my worth is? Yes, I'm going to find my wish fulfillment one way or the other. That's what person B is saying. So let's see what your mutual energies are here now. The Devil in reverse, yes, letting go of toxic patterns, toxic cycles. Three of Cups in reverse. And then the Judgment upright. Let's see what this is. The Devil, Spirit. What's this Devil card? The minute person B lets go of anything that is bringing them down, I'm not saying person A is a devil or toxic. The relationship became a bit toxic because one person was winning and the other person was always losing. So now that this Empress has found, their self-worth, faith in their own self and what they deserve, now this person is on their way to anything they want. This is the queen above all queens. So the minute they have realized their worth, this chapter of their life, which was toxic, where they had fear, anxiety, there was regret of the past, always feeling that they're waiting around for somebody to validate them, this became a toxic pattern in person B's life. And now the minute they are now acknowledging, I don't have to wait around for somebody who's not giving me what I deserve. Somebody is ascending here, big time to Empress level here. Three of Cups, Spirit. Again, the Devil in reverse. they are getting out of third parties. Somebody is getting out of third parties, of anything toxic in their life. It's almost like sitting with a checklist to say, this works for me, this doesn't work for me, this works for me. And the minute all this toxicity is going from their life, guess what's happening? Judgment. This is like a brand new life. Is the universe is going to start blessing. Let's see who, okay? Is it going to be a rebirth for the connection spirit, or is it for the person who's had now the faith in themselves to nurture themselves and respect and have faith in their own capabilities? So what's this judgment card, spirit? Judgment. Oh, wow. See what's in store for you, Taurus. And you're not going to really need anyone else to give you this, okay? Why? Because A, you're the Empress now. You're coming across as the pre-Empress and the Empress. This brand new life is coming because now you have started seeing through anybody who's going to come into your life, who's going to be a trickster, anyone who's going to bring you empty false promises. You're saying, if there's no clarity, I'm not getting into anything that's not going to give me what I deserve. Okay? You're letting go of the self-imposed prison. This card is so interesting because there is no second person in this card, Taurus. This person is alone but keeps themselves trapped by fear. There is a road right in front of them which is open. I think you found that road, Taurus. You've removed the blindfold from your eyes. You can see clearly. And now, I think you are now elevating yourself first to respect yourself. And the minute you start doing that, Taurus, this is what's coming for you. Your perfect partner will appear. Now, whether it's going to be your past person who's going to see you in a different light, or it's going to be somebody new, I have no clue. But your first step that you've taken to have faith in your own self is what's going to lead you to what you've always wanted. The perfect partner, the beautiful home, the happily ever after. Okay? You've been waiting before for people to validate you. Now I see my Taurus gang, thumbs up. Alright? So that's what I have for you, Taurus. Love and light. Take care. Namaste. See you soon.